What's up everyone, this is Justin from Make Supply, and in this video we will be doing a build along tutorial for the iPhone 6 sleeve. This template is available for purchase from the Make Supply Etsy store, which is linked below. It's an instant digital download, so you can print it out at home and follow along. Otherwise, we invite you to just tag along for the build process. Hope you enjoy. Alright, let's do inventory for the iPhone 6 sleeve build. First is the template, printed out on 110 pound cardstock from Staples. Beautiful green. Our leather will be using for the body panel, we'll be using the Herman Oak 3 to 4 ounce natural vegetable tan. And for the card slot, I'm gonna switch it up a little bit and use this 2 to 3 ounce English bridal leather from Wicked and Craig. I've had this laying around for a little bit, so I figure, put a little pizzazz on it. If you've never had a chance to use English bridal as a, accessory weight leather, I highly recommend it. It's a wonderful leather to work with. Number 2 X-Acto knife, CS Osborne scratch off, Goods Japan number 1 edge beveler, wing divider, cork back metal ruler, craft tool 2 millimeter diamond chisels. I have some new chisels coming from Goods Japan. Can't wait for them to get here and start using them in these tutorials. For our thread, this is Royal Wood 7-ply, waxed Irish linen, block of beeswax, tandy stitching needles, binder clips, Elmer's Pro Bond glue, the rubber mallet for using the diamond chisels, some sandpaper, wood slicker, and a piece of canvas I'll also be using for slicking down the edge. Some water for your slicking the edge, and some new edge burnishing formula that I've been working on. Kind of taking the best things of, the gum tragacanth and some other items and putting them into one. I think I finally got it to a point where I'm very happy with it, so I'll be using this to burnish edges in this video. Okay, so let's cut out this template. Alright, so let's check out this template and see what we're working with. So the sheet that you'll be printing out has three pieces on it. The front body panel, the back body panel, and the card slot. The only difference being the front body panel goes with the curved edges and has two little marking points for where the card hole, the card slot aligns. And then the back panel has the squared edges with a little marking for the curve. So just like we did in the field notes case, we're going to build this where we put this on here, the top to the bottom, and then cut the edges off once they're put together. So I will go ahead and cut this out now. Okay, just cut out my three pieces. Top panel, front panel, the back panel with the square corners, and the card slot. Now I'm going to trace them onto my leather. When you're doing your front panel, make sure to put a little mark where the two circles are with your scratch awl. That'll note where to line up the card slot. Thank you. Alright, piece number one. Second piece, and our card slot. Oops, drop my templates onto the English bridle. Okay, got all three pieces traced, and now I am going to cut these out off camera and come back and we will start construction. Alright, so I cut out the three pieces. There's some tight curves up towards the top here, so just take your time around them. Now we need to finish the edges of the parts that we will not be able to reach once this is built. So that will be the inside edge of this card slot, the top edge here, and the top edge here. So let's do that now. Water. And a little bit of our edge burnishing compound. You can use gum trag or saddle soap if you have it. And I'm going to use a piece of canvas cloth because this is very thin and very floppy, and it's hard to get, you know, a nice hold on that. So I just find it to be easier using the canvas. It's a little tricky with these parts down here. Okay, it's a little quick, but you get the idea. So now what we're going to be doing is attaching the card slot, gluing the card slot to the outside top panel. And from there, I'm going to mark all my holes. I'm going to punch them through one time, and then I'm going to attach the back. So let's get to gluing this down here. Okay, let's do this. So just remember, you're gluing the card slot to the one that already has the curves, not the square. line up the bottoms, the sides, and the edge here with the little mark you made from the template. Binder clips, you can clip this on now. Okay, I'll let that dry for a second and come back. Now that we give that a second to dry up, let's clean up the edge a little bit. So now I'm going to mark my stitching groove with a wing divider. Now mark our holes. Again, I'm using the 2mm spacing this time, a little bit closer stitch. So as I do in the other videos, I'm going to start on the top at an even point and meet somewhere down here. trying to eye that up to make it a nice even point. Let's see how close we get to a perfect line. I didn't measure this template beforehand, so I do not know. Actually, almost right on, not too bad. Okay, so now that I have my holes marked, I'm going to punch through an initial punch on this. I like to do this because, again, if you've watched my other videos, anytime there's more than two layers, I like to punch through the initial two and then put it together and then punch through the rest, because then it uses the hole you already made as a template, as a guide to keep your diamond chisel straight each time. You can do the same thing with the awl, and I think it's equally beneficial. So what we're gonna do is punch all the way around. I'm gonna do this off camera, and then come back and assemble the rest. Okay, so I went through and punched all the holes that I just marked. See this here? Just the two layers. And now I'm going to glue this panel to the back panel. And somebody's calling me. All right, line up your sides and the bottoms there. looks like I didn't use enough glue, so I gotta add some glue on here to make sure this tacks down. Okay, so that's gonna need a minute to tack down, so come back. Okay, I let that sit for a couple minutes. Should be good. Alright, good enough. Now we'll take off the corner using the curved corner as a guide. Okay. Sandpaper and clean this up. Damp sand just to help flatten it out a little bit more. Okay, and then I'm just gonna do a little groove on the back, just for good measure. At this point now, since we already have the holes in the first two layers, I'm just going to go through with my diamond chisels and punch all the way through the last layer there, and then come back and we'll be ready to stitch. Okay, just finished punching all the holes all the way around. See, here's the front and the back. So now it's time to stitch. I'm going to be using this Royal Wood waxed Irish linen tanning needles. If you need help with saddle stitching, check out the saddle stitching video I put up last week. I'm going to be doing it the exact same way. Otherwise, I am going to be stitching this off camera, so I will come back with this piece all stitched up. Okay. Just finished stitching this thing up. Front, back. Now it is time to do our edges. Rough dry sand, now a little damp sand. During damp sanding, sand all the same direction. Now we will take off the edge with our bevel. Okay, just touch it with the sandpaper one more time. Now we burnish. A little bit of water. Get that nice and damp. And then a little bit of our burnishing agent. sit for a second. Alright, take your edge burnisher and go to town. All the way around doing the same thing. Okay, it's the first round. I'm gonna take a quick break, come back, and we're gonna do one more round. Alright, had to go turn on the air conditioning, dying down here. So let's do one more round of burnishing and then put some beeswax on here, and then we will be good. This time around, I'm going to use the canvas. It shines up real nice. We'll have this burnishing compound that I created here available for sale pretty soon. Just gotta work out a couple more kinks with the formula and it'll be complete. Works really good. It slicks down super quick. Alright, it's looking good. Get some beeswax on here. Okay, let's finish up those edges there. Let's see if I can get this on the camera. It's a little tough to see. You can see a nice shine. Okay, let me go find an iPhone 6 to put in here because I only have an iPhone 4. So I had to go get my girlfriend's phone. One second. Okay, got the iPhone here. Put it in. It's going to be a little bit tight at first, especially if you're using veg tan, especially an unoiled veg tan like I'm using. But it will slide in, and it'll make its way further down as it breaks in. So I would highly recommend giving this a nice oil prior to using. It'll soften it up and make it an easier fit. Here's our finished product. And the card slot, you can throw some cards, some cash in there. And you're good to go. If you have any comments or questions, you can post them in the comments section of the blog post or the video, or email me directly. If you do end up making this and you're on Instagram, hashtag it as MakeSupply and I'll feature it on our Instagram account. Thanks for tuning in.